Hello, Lyssa here. So I was having a really interesting conversation with a person the other day. And as we were talking, one of the things that came up was a concept that shows up in the corporate world that he works in called where they're looking at how they make decisions. And he said, you know, we really talk about one-way door or two-way door decisions. And I was really interested in that idea, that concept. And I'm like, please tell me more. I'd love to hear this. And he said, well, one-way door decisions are those decisions that you're going to make. And they are a one-way door. You make them, you walk through them. There's no coming back. On the other hand, there are a lot of decisions that are two-way door decisions. So you can walk through them. But if they're not working, you can walk back through them and come back through that door. It's a two-way door. And it started to be this like a little concept that, not even such a little concept, but a concept that I thought, that is a really unique, easy way to start to think about the decisions that we're making. Are they one-way door decisions or two-way door decisions? And I think, especially with the people when I'm talking to my clients and they're super perfectionist about things or really highly critical of themselves, I think sometimes we take two-way door decisions and make them one-way door decisions. And that would be a danger because we're putting too much importance on the level of that decision. So for instance, a one-way door decision, like I'm going to quit my job and go try and find something else to do, or I want to change my career completely. That may be a one-way door decision. On the other hand, depending on the relationships that you've engendered in the place that you work, depending on the quality of the work that you've done, your organization might hire you back. It might be a two-way door decision. But if it is going to be a one-way door decision, what are the smaller two-way door decisions you might need to be exploring so that when you make that one-way door decision, you're doing it with a very clear sense of, I've done all of the homework I need to do. I've made all of these smaller two-way door opportunities available to myself to go in and see if I even like it, because I can always pull out. So an example of this was when I was working for the military, I didn't want to just quit my job. I mean, I really loved my clients. I liked the people that I was working with. I enjoyed my job. And yet I really wanted to be in a private practice for myself. So one of the two-way door decisions that I made was while I was still working for the military, I started getting myself onto insurance boards or insurance panels really is what they are. So that when I were to go out into private practice, I would already be on panels so that I would already start to have a referral source. Now, just because I was getting myself on these panels didn't mean that I had to quit my job or that I had to go into private practice, right? Like I was creating a private practice, but I didn't have to accept clients just because I gotten onto the panel. So it was a two-way door decision. It started to give me a sense of what it might be like if I were preparing myself, right, for this bigger one-way door decision. Another thing that I did was I rented a shared office with another two therapists so that we could trade off evenings. So I'm just working one or two evenings a week versus quitting my job, putting a lease together on an office, right? Like, so there were all of these two-way door decisions that I was making that had a very low cost, low impact, that I could have a sense of trying on this new outfit. And that's another good example, right? You go into a store, you might try on multiple outfits. You're only making the decision maybe on one, but you're going to try on a few. Those are all two-way door decisions. Frankly, anything you buy at a store is probably a two-way door decision. But for the purpose of this analogy, the ones you have all these opportunities to try things on before you make the final decision that is the one-way door decision. So anyway, I just love this concept. So I share it with you. Am I making a two-way door decision into a one-way door decision? And if it is a one-way door decision, what are the two-way door decisions I need to be playing with prior to really committing to that one-way door decision? So I hope this was useful. I wish you all the best and talk to you soon.